Hi friends, today we are going to study a normal system, cubic system galenotype. This is one of the important system from the normal class, cubic system. And as per the rest of the whatever we have, the systems are there, like tetragonal, hexagonal, orthorhombic, monoclinic, triclinic. There we have the names of the axes are different. Here we don't have any axis. Now here, whatever the names of any particular model from the cubic system is given, it is given on the basis of total number. Yes, so that is the total one, but rest one, they are as per their number, whether it is two faces, spinacoid, whether it is four vertical faces, is a prism, whether it is four inclined faces, is a dome we call, or eight inclined faces, it is a pyramid. That is the normal forms we have. And based upon which axis are going to cut, we have the different types. But here in the cubic system, typically you are going to see different names are given on the basis of their number of faces. Because here, whatever faces are available, whether it is 6 faces, 8 faces, or 48 maximum. So there what we have, 36 faces are there. So there we'll have the faces which are there. In that, we are going to see that all are identical. So that will be the easiest way to identify a model from cubic system galenotype. Yes, so I am Dr. Sajid Undekar, associate professor and head department of geology, is Pune College Arts Commerce Science Camp, Pune, Maharashtra, India. I welcome you to my channel PC Geo Kimberlite. PC Pune College, Geo is a geology. And kimberlite is a source of diamond. So from here, there will be number of diamonds are coming out. So we are given a kimberlite for this particular YouTube, and hope in the future also the diamonds will be coming from this department. So let's will start actual the cubic system. Now in this cubic system, first what we are going to have is the crystallographic axis. Very, very important one. In the cubic system, there are the three crystallographic axes. A axis, B axis, C axis. A running from front to back, B running from right to left, and C running from top to bottom. Say A running from front to back. Front is given positive sign, left is given back is given negative sign. Whereas the B axis running from your right to left. Always remember, whenever the observer is there, from right to the left, running from right to the left is your B axis. Right given positive sign, left is given negative sign. And whereas the C axis is running from top to bottom, and all the three axes, I don't get this one because of COVID-19. Our department has been closed. So I'm making the video from my home. So I don't have the all the whatever the available material is there for showing you this models and all that. I don't have. So we try to find out the way and means and try to complete this particular topic, which will be a very, very important one. In this system, there are the three axes. All the three axes are equal in length, very important. All the A, B, C axes which are there, they are equal in length. So these axes will be denoted as A1, A2 and A3. And all these three axes are perpendicular to each other. Again, important significance. That's why we are going to get interchangeable. So axes are interchangeable. That is A1 become A2 or A2 become A3, A3 become A1. So whichever axis you are going to make out them. So in that A1, A2 and A3, they are the interchangeable. So that will be there. A1 running from front to back, running from top to bottom. All these three axes are interchangeable. So here I given you. So A1 running from front to back, A1 positive sign front side, back is given. So here back should be a dotted one. So I could not get the diagram which is proper one. So here whenever you draw in a journal, see that the back side we could not see. So that should be always make as a dotted. So immediately the examiner understood that this is the back side of that particular A1 axis. A2 running from right to left, A2 right side is given positive side, left is given negative side. Whereas A3 running from top to bottom, the top is given positive sign and bottom is given negative sign. Here, the A1 which is running from front to back, A2 running from right to left, and A3 running from top to bottom. A equal to B, B equal to C. So A1 A2 and A3. So A1, A2, A3, and all are perpendicular together. So due to this relation, now in cubic system, we have 9 planes. Maximum planes are there in all the 7 normal class we have in that system. We have the maximum plane in this. So this is the model of the cubic system. I don't have the model, so I prepare a model for you. So now whenever you want to draw a plane, remember now, whenever you want to draw a plane, you have to draw first from the center of the face, from front to back. Yes, this is your front face to the back. You have to draw a line. Say example, I'm going to draw a line. So if I draw the line, see now the crystal is divided. Come to the next one, crystal is dividing. Come here, crystal is dividing. Now come your original position. Now you will see that this is your first plane. What will be center of the face from front to back you have drawn. So this is one plane. Come to next one, left to the right. Try in the center of the face from left to the right. So I have done left to the right. It divides. Continue. It's left to the right. Continue. You can continue this face. It divides. So a plane, imaginary plane, which divides a crystal into two equal parts, and the left will be the right, will be the mirror images, or front will be the back mirror images. Now we have seen the front to the back, that is center of the face. Second one, from the left to the right, center of the face, and the third one, horizontal. So these three are the, we got the planes, and these are called as the axial plane. Axes are passing from the center of the face. A1 axis running from front to back, A2 running from right to left, and A3 running from top to bottom. So all the three axes will be there. Your C axis, A1 axis, and this is your A2 axis. This will become A3 axis. C is become now A3 axis. So these three axial plane you have drawn now. Now next one, you have to draw the diagonal plane. Now, there are 8 corners, 4 on the top and 4 on the bottoms. Clear? Second one, front and back. This is one pair of two similar faces. Left and right, it is a pair of two faces of similar pair. Top and bottom, it is another pair of two similar faces. All 6 are similar, but out of this, front and back become one pair, left and right become one pair, and top and bottom one pair. Now, we'll focus front and back. We'll try to draw a plane in the front and back. So what I'm going to do, whatever we have the corner, we'll join a line from corner to corner, opposite. If I draw here from the front, what is happening? This more face, square face, is divided. And exactly mirror image is there on the opposite side. Now what is happening? If you extend this one, it is passed from A-H, and once it is coming on the back, it is exposed on the back. Again, it is coming through the edge. Means front, we have drawn one. Now, this is one plane. Second one, I'm going to draw this way. So you pass out them, they are exposed on the back. So front, we have one this way, and this is second, two diagonal. Front and back contain two diagonal. Similar one. Now come the left and right. Bring it over here. This is your one plane and this is your another plane. So left and right contain two. Similar way, top and bottom also contain two. Top also contain two. So here front two, side two, and top and bottom two. So total 6. And these are going from the corners. So they are the diagonal one. So 3 axial, 6 diagonal. This is a very simple one. First, center of the face, and that is also front to the back. Remember, this is any model of any system, always do it. Center from front to back. If it divides, this is one plane. Then left to the right. If it divides, then it is second. Then it is divide again in the horizontal third. So this is three possibilities are done. Then in the cubic system, front and back contain two diagonal planes. The left and right contain two diagonal planes, and two top and bottom contain two diagonal planes. So there will be 6 diagonal planes. So here in this particular system, there are the 9 planes, and here to write in the bracket, the distribution, 3 axial plane and 6 diagonal. If you written this one, you will get half marks in the practical. no need to draw the axis and all that. Just the model number is required and qubit system type galena, and if you return plane of symmetry 9 plane 3 axis, you'll get 1 marks. Then axis of symmetry if you return, then center of symmetry return 1.5 marks. Rest 1.5 mark will be there for your forms and indices. If form 3-4 are there, is okay. If one form is there, automatically 2 marks will be given for the type and system 1 mark, then plane axis and center of symmetry 1 mark, and rest 1 form and indices. So this is the distribution. So I'm giving you the simplest way how this examiner is giving the marks. So how the marks will be cutting out. So in the examination, what is happening? You just write down the model number and everything is blank. Nothing is there. So don't make that mistake. This is a simple way. I have shown you the model, how to find out the planes. Now come to the next one. Axis of symmetry is, what is axis of symmetry? It is an imaginary axis through which the model has to rotate it through 360 degrees. And you have to count number of phase occupy, the number of position, how many times, whether it is going to count 2 times, whether it is count 3 times, whether it is going to count 4 times, or whether it counts 6 times. That means 1 of 2 fold, 1 of 3 fold, 1 of 4 fold, or 1 of 6 fold. Any one will be there, and you have to find out number of possibilities. In this particular system, it is the maximum one, cubic system, because the two relation, all the three axes are equal and they are perpendicular. Due to this, here we have maximum plane and maximum axis. Now we'll start with the simple rule. Hold in the center of the faces. Now there are the three pairs we already done. Front and back, one pair. Left and right, one pair. Top and bottom, another pair. So three pairs are there. So assume now your A1 will be passing from this one, A2 running from right to left, and A3 running from top to bottom. This is there. So now hold in the C axis. Mark is there. I'm going to rotate through 360 degrees, 90 degree one phase, 180 second time, 270 third time, and 364 time. Along this C axis, when I'm going to rotate, it is 104 fold. Come along the A axis. 1, 2, 3, and 4. So 104 fold along the A axis. Come to the next B axis. 1 of 2 fold, 1 of 4 fold is 1, 2, 3, and 4. So 104 fold. So here front and back axis, when you rotate imaginary axis through 360 degree, 4 faces coming the same position. So it has become 104 fold. Then B, again on that axis, if you rotate through 360, again faces occupying the same position 4 times. That becomes 104 fold. Then along the C axis, when you're going to rotate, it becomes 104 fold. So here 104 fold, 104 fold, 104 fold. That means there are the three axes. Three axes showing you 4 faces coming regularly at particular spot on the front side. So three axes of 4 fold. So here three planes are there. Along this, you are just hold in the center of the face. These are the axes. Along this, if you rotate, you get 104 fold. That means three axes of 4 fold symmetry. We got the answer. Yes. First plane is three axes of 4-fold symmetry in the center of the faces. This is clear? Yes. Next one, very, very important one. 1, 2, 3, 4. These are the 4 corners on the top, 4 corners on the bottom. And why these corners are 8 corners are there or identical? Whatever the edges are there, they are equal in height. So they are identical. All faces are identical. So corners we can count. 8 corners are there. If you join them, how many lines you are going to get? 4 lines. If you join the 8 corners, we are going to get the 4 line. For example, if you join this way, this corner and the bottom one, yes, this will be there. So now I'm going to join this corner and hold this corner. I'm going to rotate. Now this face, 1, twice and thrice. 1, 2 and 3. One of 3-fold symmetry. So now how many corners are there? 4. So 4 of 3. Yes, so we have 8 corners are there. If you join them, 4 lines are there. So along these 4 lines, if you rotate the model through 360. Now this model is not exactly cube. So you might be feel that it is not been matching now. Assume now this is a, like a cube. So all faces are identical. So when I am going to rotate the face through 360, there will be three faces coming the same position. So it will become one of three fold, one of three fold, one of three fold, one of three. No need to rotate now. One it is given, everyone is giving, because here the faces are identical, edges are identical, corners are identical. So one of three fold, one of three fold, one of three fold, and one of three fold. That is four of three fold symmetry. Now all edges are identical. Now count them. How we are going to count? Four horizontal top, four horizontal bottom, four vertical one. So how many are there? 12 edges. Four on the top, four on the bottom, four vertical. Hold this one. Edges, opposite edges. One, two. One, two. So any one, if you rotate, one of two fold. So 12 edges are there. If you join them, you're going to get one of two fold, one of two fold. So six of two fold. You can see now. Total 13 axes, three of four fold, four of three fold, and six of two fold. Is what we are going to make out here. Nine plane, three axes, six diagonal. Yes. So now we are going to get 3 and 4, 6 as it is. If you write down on the lower side, automatically the middle number you are going to get 3, 4, 6. Yes, these are the numbers we are going to make out. 3 axes, 4 corner, and 6 edges lines which are there. 4 lines along the corners, 6 lines along the edges. And now I can see now very interesting one. I also got from one of my student. I asked them, what are the similarity you are going to see in this particular axis of symmetry? One of the girl has told me that, sir, in the 13 axis, if you see whatever we have written, the three axis of symmetries we have written, 3 of 4 fold, 4 of 3 fold, 6 of 2 fold, there is one common. What is that common? That if you make the multiplication of these three, we'll find out the total is 12. Yes, if you make the multiplication of these two, 3 of 4 fold, it is 12. 4 of 3 fold is a 12. 6 of 2 fold is 12. So you start with the minimum 3 of 4 fold, 4 of 3 fold, 6 of 2 fold. Otherwise, if you see the axis 3, axial 1, then number is increased 4, number is increased 6. So this will number increase, axis number will increase your from your left to the right. Now I can see on the top, highest number, rule says. Yeah, there is a rule. Whenever highest number of axes are there, it will always give you minimum. That is a 2. 6 of 2 fold. You can see now, if you come here, 2 will become 3. 3 will become 4. So 3 of 4 fold, 4 of 3 fold, and 6 of 2 fold. This is there that I have learned from my one of the student. And I've very much appreciated this girl who has to taught me. This is the so 9 plane, 13 axis, center of symmetry is present. Next one, the center of symmetry. If you hold imaginary corners, both the corners will have the same corner. If I hold edge opposite side, the same edge, same orientation. If I hold a face opposite, also the same face. So any faces, edges, corner, if you hold from the center, they are at an equidistance. So center of symmetry play present. So here, whenever you're going to remember now the cubic system, this is the way I have given the trick. Cubic system, galenotype, 9 plane, 13 axis, center of symmetry present. 9, 13, this is a remember, 9, 13. So in that 9, three axes are there. So automatically we get 6. So when you write the 13, 6, 3 and 6 already we have on the top, right on the bottom, automatically you will get the center. So highest number 6 will give you 2, then 4 will give 3, and 3 will give you 4. So this is where you have to make out the shortcuts to remember the element of symmetry of the cubic system galenotype. 9 plane, 13 axis, center of symmetry is present. Yes, we'll go to the next one. The first form, the cube form. Yes, this is what we have, the cube form. And whenever we write the indices, we write the indices of the front face. Your A1 axis pass through the center of the face. Whenever it pass through, what is happening from the center? This face is cutting at a unit distance. That is 7 divided by 7 radius. So the whenever it's going to cut the face, it will be cutting at a unit distance. So whenever cutting unit distance, we call it is a 1. And when it is cutting at an infinity, for example, your B axis, this is your B axis, it is not going to cut your face. So they are cutting at an infinity. So when it is going to infinity, then we'll write as a 0. Yes, so B 0, the B axis will pass from this one, C vertical, it is also remain 0. So 1 0 0. So indices of the cube is 1 0 0. 1 0 0. If you want to find out, it will be 0 1 0. It will be 0 0. So this will be indices of nothing but the pinacoids, what we are going to write in the other systems, right from tetragonal, monoclinic, triclinic, hexagonal, or hexagonal 0 0 0 1, because one more axis will be there, so there will be number will be more. 1 0 0 will be there in tetragonal system, orthorhombic system, monoclinic system, or triclinic system. But hexagonal, we have just the vessel pinacoid. So cube will write the front face 1 0 0. It consists of six similar face. Each face cuts your one axis, remain parallel to the other axis. But now here in this case, it's going to cut your A axis. So we'll always write the indices of the front face. So 1, 0, 0. Next one, octahedron. Yes, octa means 8. Hedron means faces. Whenever 8 similar faces are there, we call it is a normal pyramid. Now here it is called as octahedron. On the basis of number of faces, they are given the name. Octa means 8, hedron means faces. Now the model number is also 111 and it indices also 11, because octahedron, 8 similar faces, pyramid is there, it cuts all the three axes. Now the whatever we have this one, in the case of the cubic system, whatever the axes are there, they are passing from the center. But when it is come the octahedron, it pass from the corners. Yes, from the corner which are there. And these two forms, cube and octahedron, very, very important. Rest of the form which are there, they are based on this one. Say example, whatever the cube is there, if this cube is divided into 4, then it is called as, the name is given first, the smaller one, tetra, 4 faces. One large cube face is divided into 4. So it is called as tetra. How many bigger faces? 6. So tetrahexahedron, this is the way the name has given. Simple one, first we have to identify the what is the common form. What are the big faces are there? And now in that big faces, how many faces are there? If 4 faces are there, write down the smaller name first, tetra. How many bigger faces? 6, tetrahexahedron. Similar one, octahedron, 8 faces. Now each 8 face, a single octahedron face is now divided into 3-1, then trisoctahedron. If 6 are there, hexaoctahedron. This is the way. This is a very, very useful tips are there. You will be get easily available, and you have to remember this way. Trisoctahedron. Now octahedron is now each octahedron face. Here you can see this octahedron has divided 1, 2, and 3. It is divided into 24, and these are the isosceles triangles are there. Again, the axis will pass through the what we have the corner. Now here what is happening? It consists of 24 isosceles triangles are there, and each face going to cut your two axes at shorter in length. Two axes at shorter in length and the third axis at a longer in length. When the two axes cutting at a shorter in length, one is cutting at a longer in length. Now I'll just clarify how these indices are we are going to write down. Whenever I told you, if the axis is going to cut your face, it is 1. If it is remain parallel, it is 0. Yes. And alphabetically, H, I, J, K, L. These are the symbol alphabets we are going to use. H indicates smaller axis. K indicates intermediate axis. And L is intermediate longest one. In case of the hexagonal, we are going to use I also. So, but in the normal, we have the 6 which are there. They are the normal type is there. So H is the smaller one. K is the intermediate one. L is the longest one. Now in this system, the two the face is going to cut your two axes at a shorter distance. So we'll write shorter in which alphabetically coming first, H. So HH, and longer, third is longer. So L, HHL. This is the way you have to remember the trisoctahedron. Yes, rhomb-duodecahedron, rhomb shape. Yes, the square face is there. Just it is pull out from the two ends, automatically you'll get the rhomb shape. And the best example is the garnet mirror. Yes, rhomb-duodecahedron. And now in this 12 rhomb shape faces is there, and each face is going to cut your A1 and A2 axis, remaining parallel to the C axis. So 1 1 0. Yes, so we'll always write the front indices. We don't write the back indices, we'll write the front indices, rhomb-duodecahedron. With the shape itself, we'll immediately recognize the model of rhomb-duodecahedron. Next one, hexa-octahedron. Now, each octahedron face, this is the octahedron. You can see this big octahedron. And now this big octahedron is now divided into six faces. And whenever this 6 into 8, 48 faces, yes, it is consist. Each face is going to cut all the axes at unequal in length. Hexa-octahedron, H shorter, K intermediate, L is the longest. This is the way you have to calculate. Hexa-octahedron, HKL. All the three axes are going to cut. H first, shorter distance, K intermediate one, L longest. We could not write L first. Remember, whenever you write, you have to write in order, alphabets. H first, then K, then L. This is the way you are going to use it out here. Hexa-octahedron, 48 similar triangular faces. Yes. Now the next one is a cube. Now each cube face is divided into four faces. Yes, so this big face is now divided into four. So tetrahexahedron. Tetrahexahedron. So this is a total 24 similar faces, and each face is going to cut your A1 and A2 axis at unequal in length and remaining parallel to the C axis. So when it is remaining parallel to C, means C will become zero. And they are cutting at unequal. So H first, then K. We don't write K and L. We have to write first H, then K. L we don't use. Whenever the two axes are going, cutting at unequal distance, H, K, and 0 we have to use. So tetrahexahedron is HK0. Remember this one, the cube divided, each cube face is divided into 4. So tetrahexahedron HK0 is. This is the trapezohedron, kite-like shape, trapezium shape, 24 similar face. Yes, so here also interesting now. Yes, it is going to cut the two axes at longest in length and third axis at the shorter in length. So we can't write HH, two equal at a longer than third is at a shorter in length. So shorter means we have to write the first one. H we have to write first. There are two at a longest distance, LL. So HLL, trapezohedron is HLL. This is where you have to write down. With the help of the kite shape, you have to immediately recognize this is a trapezohedron. Yes, very, very interesting one. A rule for holding position. How you are going to hold the model. Whenever you rotate a model along the axis, imaginary axis, and if it gives you one of fourfold symmetry, it's give you one of fourfold symmetry, that becomes your one axis. The next one, whichever the axis which is giving you, so one more one of fourfold is there. One of, so a rough front and back, this face we are rotated, one of fourfold. Left, right, we when you rotated, one of fourfold. Then top and bottom, one of fourfold. So these three will become your axis. So the three axis of fourfold symmetry should coincide with the your crystallographic axis. This is the way, once you get this one, you will get the complete picture, how the whole model, then which is a prism and everything will pen easily find out the forms and immediately can recollect the indices. Now this is the model what we have seen. The first one, hexahedron, octahedron, rhomb-duodecahedron, trisoctahedron, tetrahexahedron, cube. Then the next one, octahedron. Now the cube is divided into tetrahedron. The cube is divided into trisoctahedron. Cube is octahedron is divided into tetrahexahedron. Yes, the cube is divided into tetrahexahedron. Then octahedron is divided into two. One is tris octahedron, next one is hexaoctahedron. Then rhombdodecahedron and trapezohedron. So this is the way, this is the models which we have practically as well as theory you have. I hope after the pandemic the department is open again, I will reshoot this one with the model. I can show you how we can find out in each model the indices. Now here I could not show you the indices, that part it is remain with me. I hope I can that your doubts will be clear very soon once department will be open. Thank you. Have a nice day. Visit my PC Joe Kimberlite YouTube channel and enjoy my videos. Like this video and share it. Thank you. And subscribe it.